Something underneath. I'm gonna put some devices. These are whatever they tuning devices, you know, they're like not really vibration isolation. Two down and one up, that would give me pinpoint sound change. Okay, two down and one up. Okay. Interesting. Okay. So what we're gonna use is some of Teddy Boy's tweaks. He's got these are Synergistic Research. These are called MIGS. Do you know what MIGS? Do you know who MIGS is in Silence of the Lambs? You don't want to get MIGS'd. Trust me. Anyways, so these are MIGS. They're like stainless steel cups. They got little teeny things in here. They look like waveguides of some sort. And they're kind of glued in the bottom or whatever, machined around them. Interesting device. Interesting is definitely, they're interesting. I'll bet you we're going to hear these for sure. I don't really know many of the Ted stuff that you don't really totally hear. Like, it's all of it's pretty evident. Like, there's never been one where I was like, I don't hear it. I always hear it, for sure. Don't know that it's always the thing that I want, but I definitely hear it, for sure. Now, let's see. Okay, so we're doing two down and one up. Okay, we're going two down and one up. Oh, boy. Anybody else see that coming? I'm sure you did. So I gotta keep, see, I had some under the, that's what's messing us up is I've got, okay, so let's see what we got here. Let's do the same song. Cool, man. I mean, it gave, I felt a little like stronger, like some definition. It gave some weight or something to that vocal, anchored it almost a little bit more. It says that the two down and one up is for pinpoint soundstage. Well, we already had that, so I don't think it gave us, it didn't really give me more. I mean, let's see. It says, Okay, you hear an immediate pinpoint presentation of images. The combination is especially pleasing in rooms that are very damped for people who prefer intimate quiet, whatever. Okay, so yeah, I felt it was kind of like I could hear it in the low frequency. I could hear it kind of across the band. Now let's flip them over, and that's supposed to be ambient sound stage. It says especially pleasing when room acoustics are more live. Okay, so you hear a more ambient soundscape that is especially pleasing. Okay, whatever. Slightly more liquid presentation. Okay, so let's listen to the other way and see. I'll be right back. I'm not going to put you through me doing this. Okay, I was able to do it a little better that time. Okay, so we'll go back and listen to it again. Let's listen. See if it changed.
See the sleep that rests upon the quiet street. Standing on, is it time to go away? Try again some other day. These are worthy years to say goodbye.
Okay, so that one, I think it sounded a little different. The bass sounded to me a little bit more woolly. Like the bass was too much. Like I didn't like the bass sort of in that one. And the vocal seemed like it had a lot of shh, you know, kind of like not necessarily sibilance, but still, yeah, maybe sibilance on top at the beginning of the vocal. We'll have to listen to that back again and compare side by side. So that's kind of interesting. Now, the more I listen to this, what my guess is, and this is a complete guess, got no idea if this is right or not, but okay, so what I'm hearing is I'm hearing something additive. I'm hearing that something more is there that was not there before. So all I can deduce is that the feet that we put in are adding something. Now, how would they add something? They look like they're resonant type devices. That thing looks like it rings at a certain frequency. It's got to. I mean, if I pull that thing off and I ping it with my finger, I put that, say I put it upside down and put a stick, a little, or like a needle or something in that waveguide, that might ruin the way the waveguide works. I don't know, maybe. But I'll bet you that bowl rings and then that waveguide resonates together. It increases the resonance of that piece, and it probably sends vibration into the chassis. This is just my guess. It could be totally wrong, but I'm feeling like those things, you know, juice the chassis with vibration at a certain frequency, and it changes the sonic of what we're hearing. Because it does not seem like it's taking things away or stripping it down. It seems like it's adding something. So it's, while interesting, the jury's still out. Like I would need to spend more time trying to determine if I'm correct. I would be trying to vet, like, does it just add something to everything I put it on? You know, and if it did, I don't really like additive that much. I like things that strip away veils, things that strip away and let you hear more of what's underneath, what's in there, what's in the music. That's what I kind of look for. Those are the kind of tweaks that I like. By the way, too, and I've said this before, you know, your audio of hi-fi rig, you don't just plug it in and then it's ready to go, okay? Like, this is a consistent tuning thing. And at least at the very first, when you're setting up, you need to tune your rig. It takes a little while, you know? It can take a couple weeks. Okay, so the next thing we're going to try are these little puppies. Can't remember the name of them, but they have, like, an air suspension. These are like you can, it's like an accordion kind of, you can press them in. So it's like a little drum kind of a thing that has, like, this taut cover a little thing on it that lets air through, so it's kind of like a mesh or something, but it's pretty hard, and it's got like a, I think it's got like a rubber band or something in there that makes these, they're like little suspension, air suspension things, with felt. So we'll see what that sounds like. Try that real quick. Okay, let's listen now and see what we got. Thank you.
away. Try again some other day. These are worthy years to say goodbye.
Okay, so that tamed down a little bit the bass. I mean, the bass is still full and everything, but it just wasn't so like woolly kind of, you know. It was a little more in its place. Kind of a softer sounding thing, but I liked it though. It was nice. Okay, next I'm gonna do, well, if I can find that other damn puck. Gonna do Black Diamonds. I gotta find the puck. I'll be back. Hold on. Okay, now I've got Black Diamond Racing Cones in with pucks. They're number fours, in case anybody knows what they are. I have two cones at the back pointed down into the pucks, and then the front is just hovering. It's because of the weight of the cables, I can just keep the front. I don't even need anything under it. So there's two cones on the back holding it. So let's see if we get something else.
Upon the quiet street, we're standing on. Is it time to go away? Try again some other day. These are worthy years to say goodbye.
So that was the Black Diamond Racing Cones. You know, it's where I'm hearing it most is it's the kind of like the mix between the highs, you know, and the sibilance on his voice, and then the you know how unruly or is the bass, or how big or flabby or tight or whatever is the bass. At least in this song, that's where I'm hearing it. The easiest place to tell what's going on. So let me go get one last thing. Okay, and here are the 11 or the VERASTARR Veramids. This is my design. Let's see what it does.
See the sleep that rests upon the quiet street we're standing on. Is it time to go away? Try again some other day. These are words.
I hate that, man. I was supposed to do it for a minute, but I get spaced out when the music's sounding good. Yeah, those sounded pretty killer. I can't wait to go back and listen to that. Those are the Veramids. Anyway, so we did a little checking out of vibration isolation. It's pretty much on the you know, underfoot, the footers things. I don't know, man. I like mine the best. Is it no wonder? Well, probably because I designed it. I'm going to listen to more music, and I'll see you.
See ya.